Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the fastest hour in radio. Welcome to the PM show with Larry and Nancy Manetti. Today, Larry and Nancy are on assignment. I believe they're actually in the lovely Hawaiian Islands getting ready to film for Magnum.
Oh, really?
That's the fabulous Tomas across the glass over there, Fab T. Yeah, I hear, pray tell, that they're doing a couple stops, actually. They're doing like a Hawaiian trip, and then they're going to be hitting the heartland of our, well, I shouldn't say the heartland, the Philadelphia area. So I guess that would be kind of like our roots, our historic roots of this country.
Right.
So from one side of the country to the next. So for the next few weeks, we're going to have some great guests, great information here on the show. Of course, great fill-in hosts, me and Fab T being a couple of them.
Oh, okay. Sounds wonderful.
Yeah, we're the fill-ins.
Yes.
But that being said, we have a bunch of great guests on the show today, guys. Today, we're going to be talking with Robert David Hall. Around here, we call him David, but Robert David Hall is probably one of the most recognizable faces on CSI. He's been with them for seasons and seasons, season after season after season after season. So we're really looking forward to talking to David Hall coming up soon. Also, guys, we have news of the weird and wacky. Yeah, apparently Chris and Bruce Jenner.
Oh, yeah.
There's something going on over there. And, you know, I'm not really one for the celebrity beef and juice, but that is one story. You know, I was a big fan of Bruce Jenner when he was Olympian.
Oh, yeah.
You know, way back in the way back. Yeah, mm-hmm. And so kind of shocking the way things develop. We'll find more about that as well. Yeah, and of course, there's a 63-year-old love story, Tomas. I got to tell you about this one. This is for the lovebirds out there. We'll talk about that, but a couple had been married after 63 years of not being together, being apart.
Really?
But there's more to the story, though. It's not just a simple love story. It's quite complicated. We'll find out about that later on in the show. And apparently people are microwaving their iPhones.
What?
Yeah. People are microwaving their iPhones, and there's a good reason why. If you could imagine this.
I would like to hear.
Yeah. So we'll find out a little bit about that. This crazy criminals. We got some more crazy criminal stuff coming up. We got a man who pretended to be a police officer for more than 20 years.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, this reminds me of back in the day. You remember when the political climate, Tomas, was heating up a little bit here in the United States? You know, of course, we had the Dems versus the Reps.
Yeah.
And it was this big, you know, the big hoorah and everyone. And there was that guy who claimed to be like a World War Vietnam vet. Do you remember this guy? You could claim to be a Vietnam veteran.
Yeah, I sort of remember him.
Yeah, he was like a congressman or a senator or something. Maybe he was a local. And whatever he was this politician who claimed to be a veteran and
right.
was speaking on behalf of veterans. Well, come to find out, he never served. This is kind of ringing of that.
And did some lady catch him?
Yeah. Yeah, she questioned him on it.
Exactly.
Yeah, he couldn't answer mm-hmm. the question. She says, wait a minute, I don't believe you. And then she did a little background checking and found out. Yeah, we got another one here. 20 years, this guy impersonated a police officer. Mm-hmm. And I got to tell you, I've thought about that myself. Not that this is an admission of guilt, because it's only like in my head.
Right.
You know, I haven't actually done this, at least that I know of. But I've often thought about, like, you know, pretending to be a police officer. What do
Why?
You do? What do you do for the? I'm a cop. Oh, really? Yeah, I'm a beat cop. You know, I just.
Oh, come on.
New to the force.
I don't see myself being a cop.
Me neither. But
or even pretending to be one.
Well, I'd like to see the response I get from people. You know, the questions people ask. You know?
I mean,
it would be kind of a fun little trick to play on somebody.
Well, I guess some people like the color of authority, if you know what I mean.
Well, you know, cop, radio host.
Mm-hmm.
They're not too much different. You got to... We got to keep everybody under control.
Yeah, that's right? true.
Guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up here on the PM show. I'm Eric Hines. Across the glass, the fabulous Tomas. We'll be back right after these messages on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
Nothing says I love you, I'm thinking about you, or I miss you like a beautiful bouquet of fresh flowers from ProFlowers.com. Flowers are a festive way to dress up a birthday, holiday, or anniversary. Plus, prices start at $19.99 and include a free vase. Every bouquet is guaranteed to last at least 7 days. To send a thoughtful bouquet, go to ProFlowers.com/radio. And to receive this special offer, enter code DAISY. That's ProFlowers.com/radio, code DAISY.
Last year, a sudden inferno ended the Chicago fire season with one question. Who gets out alive? Tonight, see the stunning answer in an unprecedented season premiere where everything changes.
Over here! Man down!
and anyone could go.
Casey, you copy?
Report! Report!
Don't miss the season premiere of Chicago Fire, tonight after The Voice on NBC.
Doesn't ask for much, maybe money once or twice. I preached about education, but he never took my advice. Said there are things they don't teach you in school. Too many things they don't teach you in school. You learn them on your feet, out there in the street. So many things they don't teach you in school. Knowledge may be power, you can learn it from a book. Get your degree, get your PhD, and you still end up a crook. 'Cause there are things they don't teach you in school.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. So many things they don't teach you in school. You learn them on your feet, out there in the street. So many things they don't teach you in school.
All right, everybody. Welcome back to the PM Show. I'm Eric Hines. Across the glass is Fab T. Guys, you were just listening to Robert David Hall. We call him David around here. And that was the title track from his album, Things They Don't Teach in School. And Tomas, it was kind of hard to imbue our own little uh-huh while the song's playing.
Yeah, it was. But, you know, the first thing I think about when listening to that song is learning about how to get along with a woman.
Oh, boy. That's definitely something I'm teaching in school.
Mm-hmm.
Well, guys, without any further ado, I want to introduce our guest, Robert David Hall. We call him David around here. David, welcome to your show, buddy.
Thank you very much, Eric. How are you doing?
I'm amazed. This is great stuff. Very rarely do we have an opportunity to talk to a man who has literally so much to talk about. I mean, not only do you have this amazing music that you've put together, but also your long legacy over at CSI, and there's so much more to talk about, David. I mean, this is amazing stuff. We're glad you could join us.
Well, it's a pleasure to be with you, man. The CSI has been going on 15 years now. I think our season starts Sunday. They moved us to Sunday night, September 28th, and it's the episode one of the 15th season.
Oh, man, I'm sure there's going to be millions upon millions of viewers watching it. But, I mean, man, how did you get involved with CSI? How did this all come about?
Well, I answered an ad in Craigslist.
You're kidding me, really?
I am kidding you. No, I've been acting for a long time, and, you know, it's rare to make a living in this profession, but I was actually brought in for one episode on the fourth or fifth episode of season one, and they didn't like their original coroner. And William Peterson, who was the star of the show at the time, said after we did the scene, he'd be a good coroner. And 15 years later, it's been a real life changer. It's quite amazing.
It's absolutely amazing. Now, you know, of course, being a musician is similar in some ways to being an actor in that, you know, the stability of work and really having to put yourself out there and hustle to get a gig. Did that kind of play into this whole thing?
Well, yeah, that's pretty perceptive, man. I've been a musician since I was 10 years old, I guess. I'm married to a cellist, a classical cellist, Judy. But, you know, I made a living as a musician, but I had never actually written my own songs and that kind of stuff. And that came about because I finally kicked myself in the butt and said, finish a bunch of songs. You know, it took me forever to get to that point. But I love acting. And for the last 30 years, I've pretty much made my living as an actor. I did what you do. I worked in radio back in L.A. in the late 70s and 80s. And I loved radio. You know, and anything to avoid heavy lifting, man. That's
you, we're cut from the same cloth, my friend.
Mm-hmm. But it's fun. I know how fortunate I am, because you reach my age and you look at your friends and you love them for who they are, but very few people actually get to do what they love to do in this life. And
that's right.
I'm a very, very fortunate man.
Absolutely. Well, you know, we are fortunate, David, that we get to speak to you today. Now, tell us a little bit about this CD. Tell us how this all came together. I mean, this is your brainchild. Are all of the songs on the CD originals? Do you have a couple covers on there?
Nine of the 12 songs are original. One of my best friends is in Austin, Texas, songwriter, producer. We've been pals since he was a bartender at some club I played at down in Orange County. And he went on to have a multi-million-selling song. His name is Chris Wall. And I always knew I wanted Chris to produce it. And I got some songs together, played them for Chris. He liked some of them, but he, you know, really took me to school on this stuff and forced me to refine the songs. And then I went down to Austin to record this with an engineer named Merle Brigante, who used to play drums with Poco and Loggins and Messina, and just a great, great musician and a great engineer. And he was pals. I do all the guitar playing on this album, but Merle knew the fiddle player and the steel player, and just there's so many great musicians in Austin, Texas. It's one of the great places on earth. I guess, L.A., Nashville, New York, Seattle, places like Chicago, but and New Orleans come to mind, but Austin is a great joint, and I love it. I go down there as often as I can.
Well, it definitely feeds to your creative bug. I mean, this music, I like to call it American roots music. This is the music that we've made for, 200 years.
Well, thank you. That's what I think it is, too. People want to label stuff as country, Americana, this or that, and I don't know. I think it's either good or it's trying to be something, and I have a son that's 33, and he likes different kinds of music than I do. But that's how it's supposed to be. You know, we're all supposed to do what we can, and then throw it out there. And if somebody likes it, man, you're fortunate.
Now, have you always been playing this style of music? You know, way back in the days when you started at 10 years old,
I played everything. You know, I played. I think I started off with folk music, and then I wanted to get an electric guitar, so I played surf music and rock and roll. I've tried my hand at jazz, and I know how to read music, but I rarely do. My wife is the great reader. She can take a piece with 8 billion notes on it and make it sound beautiful. But I use a notation system. I try to the words and the idea and the feel are what I care about most.
Absolutely. Well, Robert David Hall, stay with us.
My brother is Richie.
We got the other brother on the show today. It's Robert David Hall. We call him David around here. Guys, stick around. We're going to continue our discussion. And I want to talk a little bit more about the music. And, of course, we're going to talk about the season premiere of CSI coming up Sunday, September 28th. So, guys, stick around. More great stuff coming up on the PM show with Eric Hines and the fabulous Tomas. We'll be back right after this.
Hi, I'm Nancy Manetti. If you're an animal lover like Larry and I do mean any kind of animal, then you must go to where we have been going for 20 years, Red Barn Feed and Pet. No matter what kind of pet you have, Red Barn has the lowest prices and the best quality products. Their staff is highly qualified for all of your pet questions. You know, they even have an in-store veterinarian and do vaccinations every Tuesday. So visit them at any of their four locations, Tarzana, Granada Hills, North Hollywood, and West Hills, or go to redbarnfeed.net. Also, anyone that mentions you heard this on the Larry Manetti Show gets $5 off every $40 purchase. So join the Red Barn family with the cheapest prices in town, and they're open 7 days a week.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time. Call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-881-1672. 800-881-1672. 800-881-1672. Call right now. 800-881-1672.
Hi, this is Joe Mantegna. Every time my Uncle Willie tells me about his service in Patton's Third Army in World War II, I'm reminded of what we owe the U.S. Army. 14 generations of American soldiers who have courageously defended our nation. Their stories represent the best of America and should never be forgotten. Join me to help build the National Museum of the United States Army, a long overdue tribute to all American soldiers. To learn more, visit armyhistory.org.
Trying to sell your old car? Instead, donate your vehicle to Heritage for the Blind. Pickup is free and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats, whether they run or not. Call right now and receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to over 50 locations. Call 1-800-785-9618. Donate your car today. That's 1-800-785-9618.
Oh, dear God, cried the man lost in the rain. Tired old Ford broke down, heart doubled over in pain. You know it's not supposed to happen this way, but it did, and it does every day. Trouble goes on forever, it'll get worse, it'll get better. It can go on forever, till you kick it to the side of the road. Road, till you kick it to the side of the road. Late last night your baby gave you the news. She's leaving in the morning with your lawyer on a Mexican pleasure cruise. You know it's not supposed to happen this way, but it did, and it does every day.
Picking and a grinning, that is the voice and the guitar stylings of Robert David Hall. David, this is some great music, my friend.
I appreciate that. RobertDavidHallMusic.com and iTunes and all that stuff. Hey, the player on that, the dobro player, is a wonderful woman named Cindy Cashdollar, who's played on things from Van Morrison to every country record that comes out of Austin. And she is, my mouth dropped open just to watch her, you know, sit in and add some tracks.
You know, what's the environment like when you get in the studio with so many talented musicians who've been doing this for so long? I think when people think about the music industry, they think all the glitz and the glamour and the attitudes and the drugs and the women and everything else.
Well, this was a low budget project, but I did it in a studio that was the guy's living room down in Austin, and it was perfect for me. It just made me very comfortable. I've played on sessions before in big studios, but I had never done my own thing. And singing, it's something I did in clubs and bars and things growing up, but to actually sit down and sing your own stuff, you have to be in just the right headspace to do it. And you got to find somebody that believes in your music in a comfortable place, and I was lucky to do both.
So you're telling me that the music, the last two tracks we just heard, those were recorded in a guy's living room in Austin, Texas?
Oh, yeah.
That's amazing.
And sometimes we did a couple of the songs, Everybody All at Once, but a lot of times I'll record the rhythm and the vocal track, you know, bass and drums, and then get Cindy to come in, or the violinist on this thing, the fiddler, is a guy named Gene Elder, who plays with George Strait and Lyle Lovett, and these guys are just down there, and, you know, for $100, they'll come in and, you know, give you three passes on whatever songs you want, and every one of the three passes is better than anything you ever dreamed of. So
I just got the chills. It's amazing. That is so cool.
Yeah, well, it's, I mean, there's lots of, there's lots of risk and in all of this stuff. You know, the scariest thing is not being successful or anything else. It's putting it out there. I'm working on number two, second album, and that's coming a little bit more difficult. I have some good songs, but I'm just trying to get them to the point where I feel really good about, you know, sitting down, and I'm trying to grow a little bit from the first album. It's like you're acting. When I first started acting, the only gigs that were out there were, you know, I did a lot of theater, and I did, you know, a little part on some crummy judge show, or I'd be, you know, just a sort of, you know, one line guy and everything. And gradually you build up your ability and your resume, and you study with somebody until you're good enough to actually dare to audition for something a little bit bigger. It's everything in life is a process.
You know, speaking of the process, what is the creative process like? I mean, going from, you know, a guy who is, you know, gigging around town, you know, doing cover songs at bars when you're younger, to then writing your own material. Now that you're writing your own material, you know, how does the process work? Do you get like song ideas in the middle of the night and you jot them down, or do you have like a MP3 Walkman you carry around with you to record everything? How does that work?
That's funny. I have this thing called an H4, a Zoom. I don't know if you've ever heard of those, but they're pretty cool. That's when I get serious about it. But ideas come to you all the time. This, you know, if I had allowed my brain to do this when I was in my 20s, I might be dangerous. But I the first place I go with ideas is my iPhone. I just hit that recorder thing, and I talk to myself, and I'll say something like up 2 frets, normal tuning, open D, March 3rd, 2014. The song is about this and that, and then I'll sing a little bit of it if I have a melody, or sometimes it comes to you together. You know, you get the words and the music come together. Other times you'll talk to yourself about, this is kind of like something I heard, you know, the old 97s do, or something weird. You know, it's just...
like you'll throw in like, oh, inspired by, you know.
Inspired, yeah. Yeah. Sometimes, you know, I'm not trying to bring anybody down. I lost a dear friend recently, and you don't want to just always write sad songs or death songs or something. You want to go, man, Chris would have loved this, or something like that. So inspiration comes from everywhere. I guess we just have to have our antenna out at the right time.
So, Robert, we're going to go to a real brief station break. Stick around for us, but it has been a very intriguing conversation. Cool. You mind hanging out with us?
I'd love to.
Great. Thank you so much. We'll be back right after this.
Look in this year's survey about the needs of the most vulnerable seniors, those with low income, those who are socially isolated.
I'm Aileen Ellis. This is Primetime Focus.
When we delved into the health issue with low-income seniors, they said that they're less likely to set health goals for themselves.
And they're doing less to prepare for their senior years.
For socially isolated seniors, they were more pessimistic about their immediate future than seniors nationally. And they're also more concerned about needing help from community programs than seniors in general.
For more info on the United States of Aging Survey, check the link on our website. That's Primetime Focus, brought to you by AARP. Hear all our programs on the web at aarp.org/radio.
Hi, folks. This is Larry Manetti, and many of you out there suffer from skin problems. Well, I've been telling you for months how to solve that problem. It's called Herpanicin. It's the most unique and effective formula on the market. It cleans your skin from the inside out. It gets rid of all kinds of acne on your back, your neck, your face, so you can feel and you could look like a movie star. Herpanicin is a natural supplement. It was created by Dr. Wayne Diamond and his staff, and trust me, this really works. I've been on these supplements for over a year now and never had a problem. There is no reason in the world to wake up and be afraid to look in the mirror. You trust Larry. Just try it. Call 888-467-4200. 888-467-4200.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names.
Really? Yeah.
They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
If you're struggling to find reliable senior living information for your mom or dad, then call or go online to get the free help you need during this turbulent time. Call now, 800-471-5173, 800-471-5173.
Bellawood Flooring has changed its finishing process. So for the first time ever, Lumber Liquidators is clearing out their current stock of Bellawood at unbelievable prices. Get Bellawood Red Oak Solid pre-finished hardwood for an incredible $2.99 per square foot. That's over 30% off already low prices. Even stunning solid Bellawood Bolivian Rosewood for an amazing 51% off. These are not seconds. This is first quality with a transferable 100-year warranty. So go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest you. Special 18-month financing is available. But hurry, these clearance deals end Tuesday.
Hey, this is Bodie Stroud, host of In the Garage on CRN Digital Talk Radio. Join us every Wednesday and Saturday at 10 a.m. Pacific Time, 1 p.m. Eastern. We'll talk with all my friends from the automotive and custom car business about all the latest things going on in the industry today. That's In the Garage with me, Bodie Stroud, Wednesdays and Saturdays at 10 a.m. Pacific Time, 1 p.m. Eastern, right here on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
Back in the spring, on a sunny day, my baby left me, she went away. Now she's gone, and I don't worry, 'cause I'm sitting on top of the world. She called me up from down in El Paso. She said, come back, Daddy, I need you so. Now she's gone, and I don't worry, 'cause I'm sitting on top of the world. You don't like my peaches? Don't you shake my tree? Get out of my orchard, let my peaches be. Now she's gone, 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 I don't worry, 'cause I'm sitting on top of the world.
If there wasn't one music to speak to all of mankind, I'm telling you, it's this music right here, my friend.
Oh, for sure. My, my, my. Sounds so good.
It's amazing stuff. We're on the line right now with Robert David Hall. This, a track from his CD, Things They Don't Teach You in School. It's available at all the major online resellers of music. Be sure to check it out. Robert David Hall is on the line. We call him David around here. David, welcome back to your show, buddy.
Thank you, Eric.
You know, we were talking about your CD again. For all of our listeners out there, just go on the internet. You could find it. Very easy to find. Robert David Hall, Things They Don't Teach You in School. We were talking a little bit about the creative process and kind of where you went. And listening to these tracks, I mean, this is original, you know, vocal content. These are your lyrics that you put together. How do I say this? How do I imbue this, Tomas? The idea that, you know, how do you connect with people so well with your lyrics, man?
Well, it's... I hope I do. The funny thing is you have to put them out there and take a chance. I'm not trying to write above or below anybody's head. I'm just trying to write about things that I think of and that I feel. And, you know, it's a process. You know, how did somebody write, I'm trying to think of the greatest song of all time. Some people think Stardust, and sure. some people think Stairway to Heaven. You know, it depends on the kind of music that really speaks to you. But the you know, you find, this is weird. You were playing a commercial on the break for Isolated Seniors or something, and I thought music is the great, one of the great things that being a human is about. I mean, absolutely. There's music that affects your grandmother and your parents and your kids, and the it's the sort of thing that gets us through hard times, and the way we feel about music changes, but it stays the same. You know, when you're a little kid, you just like, you love making noise, and you know, you get a little more sophisticated. But I don't, tell me if this is true to you. I find that the music people listen to a lot in high school remains with them the rest of their lives.
Oh, yeah.
I'm the eldest of five boys, and my youngest brother was a, you know, big into classic rock, but he loves the people he loved that he listened to in high school. And I try to, you know, I honor that stuff, but I listen to a lot of music. I was a music director in radio for a lot of years, but I'm just sort of naturally curious. I love seeing where my heroes go. And you know, one of my evil pleasures, I'll stay up late and watch that Guitar Center Sessions show.
Oh, yeah.
And I love that guy, Nick Harcourt. I've been turned on to more new people watching that. I mean, he has the old chestnuts, too, but some of the new people, man, music is always headed in the right direction.
Yeah, yeah. It's interesting you say that, because there is a lot of cynicism. I mean, even with new contemporary artists, they're almost cynical against themselves in some ways about the industry, where, you know, I think that people that care about music, the industry doesn't matter.
Well, we live in a time, this is interesting to me, in the 1980s, even into the 90s, people, you had to go a certain route. You had to get a record company to, you know, get behind you, sponsor you, and the odds are you would never make a living at it. You might get to do a few shows or concerts, but now anybody literally can make an album and get it out there. YouTube is an amazing thing. I'm not very bored. I mean, I'm a fairly busy guy, but sometimes just for the heck of it, I'll say Ry Cooter YouTube, you know, and I'll listen to Ry Cooter or see him do or anybody, you know, just anything you want to hear.
Well, I mean, that's kind of the beauty nowadays, is that, you know, lost footage. I mean, all this archival material that has turned up on these resources like YouTube have made it so guys like us, music fanatics or movie fanatics, you know, fans of certain actors, have at their fingertips immediate access to new material that maybe isn't brand new, but it's new to us.
You know, the one thing, this is Tomas, David.
Hey, Tomas.
The one thing that I always say about music is the fact that it's an ever-changing spirited language. And sometimes you have to understand where you have been to before you can go forward. And that's the great thing about examining other forms of music, different times, different places, because from there you can you know, figure out where you're at and how you want to express your music, your language.
I couldn't agree with you more, man. The Los Lobos comes to mind.
Oh, yes.
They, you know, not only did they want to make their own music and rock and roll and new stuff, but they also honored their mariachi heritage. And you know, those guys know where they came from.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Tomas makes a great point. To know where you're going, you have to have some kind of appreciation of where it came from. You know, it's not enough to sit in your room and listen to old Beatles records or something, because they came from somewhere, and then they influenced a whole generation of people, and the Rolling Stones did, and Elvis did, and Chuck Berry did, and Marvin Gaye did. I mean, the list is, we'd have to have a 12-hour show just to talk about influences.
Definitely.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, no kidding. Guys, right now we're on the line. We've been spending the hour with Robert David Hall. Stars on CSI, also has a great, great CD out called Things They Don't Teach You in School, self-titled album, Robert David Hall, Things They Don't Teach You in School. Robert, can you spend one more segment with us?
One more, because I got to talk about CSI or they'll kill
me. Absolutely. You know? When we come back, we're going to talk all about the great season premiere September 28th of CSI. Guys, when we come back, more from Robert David Hall right here on The PM Show.
Geico Motorcycle presents Reflections from the Road.
The day I knew I was a real biker was when I switched to Geico Motorcycle Insurance. Because real bikers, well, they know where the savings are. And you know what else makes you a real biker? A sweet tattoo. Check mine out. Just got it yesterday. It says Heal on Wheels. Wait, Heal on Wheels? Oh, man. Well, at least I got the saving money with Geico part, right?
Geico Motorcycle Insurance. See how much you could save.
Let's get down to business. You don't travel too often for work, but when you do, you want to stay where you know you'll be taken care of. That's where Choice Hotels comes in. We have everything you need to keep you on top of your game, like free hot breakfast for that much-needed morning boost, free internet to keep you in touch with home base, and a generous loyalty program so you can earn great rewards. Stay for business at Choice Hotels and book now at choicehotels.com. Great endings begin here. Amenities vary by location.
There's no better way to say I love you. I'm thankful you're in my life. I'm glad to be with you. I'm thinking about you, or I miss you. Then with a spectacular flower arrangement from ProFlowers.com. A gorgeous fresh flower arrangement is a must to dress up every birthday, holiday, or anniversary. As a special treat for you, your beautiful flowers start at an amazing low price of $19.99. And ProFlowers.com will include a free vase with floral orders. Imagine a beautiful bouquet of 100 blooms for only $19.99 with a free vase included. Every festive bouquet is guaranteed to last at least 7 days. Tell your loved ones you're thinking of them with flowers. Go to proflowers.com/radio and enter your code to receive this special offer. Enter code DAISY. That's proflowers.com/radio, code DAISY. Send a bouquet they'll never forget from proflowers.com/radio, code DAISY.
I knew a man, Bojangles, and he danced for you. In worn-out shoes, with silver hair, a ragged shirt, and baggy pants. He would do the old soft shoe. He could jump so high, jump so high, and then he'd lightly touch down.
Welcome back, everybody. This is the PM Show. Fabulous Tomas. I'm Eric Hines. We're holding it down here for the next hour. Larry and Nancy Manetti are on assignment. It's kind of gallivanting the country here, Tomas. That's what I hear.
Yeah, I would love to do that, man.
Doing a Hawaiian trip and then over to Philly.
Yeah.
To our good buddy Dave Petty's hometown. Go see the cracked Liberty Bell and celebrate with the fans and friends over there on the East Coast. So, yeah, we're looking forward to them having a great time out there and coming back and joining us for the show. Until then, we have been poised to spend the hour with Robert David Hall. David, welcome back to your show.
Who is that singing Bojangles?
I think we should probably give a shout-out to old Sammy Davis.
That's right, oh, that's Sammy great. Davis Jr.
That you know what? I love that song. I know Jerry Jeff Walker, who wrote it pretty well.
No kidding.
Wow.
And sometimes artists, you know, sometimes they make a song better, sometimes they wreck it, but Sammy Davis Jr. was a really talented guy.
He was.
He was amazing, yeah.
And that's a cool thing.
Absolutely.
You know, again, we talked about this language, David, and Sammy took it and added accents of his own language into the song and made it even more special and personal.
Well, he made it his own, and that's, yeah, exactly. That's amazing.
Well, David, I know you have a lot of stuff on your plate. Let's talk about the season premiere of CSI.
You. Yeah, September 28th. It's Sunday at 10. They moved us from Wednesday at 10. Don't ask me why. And we're following The Good Wife on CBS, oh. Channel 2 in L.A., and check your local listings kind of thing. Our stars, you know, some cast has changed, and some of us have been there the whole time. Ted Danson plays D.B. Russell. He's the big cheese. And the beautiful Elizabeth Shue from, I don't know if you remember, oh, yeah. Well, you guys are young enough to remember Adventures in Babysitting.
Oh, yeah.
But she got nominated for an Oscar for Leaving Las Vegas. And she's lovely. I dig working with her. And then we lost Paul Guilfoyle. He actually retired, the guy who played Captain Brass.
Yeah, I heard about that, yeah.
Yep. And then, but George Eads and Georgia Fox and Eric Zamanda and, let's see, David Berman. We have enough of the old to keep it going. The whole season is about, well, in the first episode, let's see, it's called The CSI Effect. And Finley, played by Elizabeth Shue, there's a car bomb in her car, and there's a lot of tension about, is she going to get blown up or not? I think you can guess the answer. And they're looking for a serial killer who's called the Gig Harbor Killer. It's somewhere up in Seattle, and Ted Danson's character used to be the big forensic expert up in Seattle, and then he moved to Vegas to be with us 3 years ago. So Danson is just, you know, at first, when I first looked at Ted, it's hard to get Sam Malone of Cheers out of your head.
I'll
tell you something. He's a good actor, really a solid actor, and he's maybe the most professional guy I've ever worked with. Always has his lines learned, always cares about making the scene as good as it can be, and goes out of his way. You know how you can tell somebody, some big star, is a good person? They learn the names of the crew within a week or two. And that's hard. That's like 120 people. And Ted, by like the third episode, he knew everybody's name. He knew who some of their wives and children were. I mean, he was just that kind of guy.
Goodness. That's cool. Yeah, what a nice guy.
Yeah, well, it is. And, you know, so I've heard people say, well, nice guys finish last and all this stuff. Danson is a winner. He's a great guy.
Well, I'll tell you know, David, I wouldn't say that's true today because we got to hang the hour with you, and I would say you're a nice guy. So
you're very kind.
I think we finished out on top.
And I want to say to Tomas, mucho gusto en conocerle y hasta la próxima. Do you speak Spanish, Thomas?
Muy poquito.
Okay. Well, you were talking about learning other things, and I hated Spanish in high school, and then suddenly I discovered there was this, you know, some songs in Spanish, and I could get a good grade if I'd come in and sing, you know, La Bamba or Guantanamera or something. So,
well, our good buddy and friend of the station, Robert Conrad, made quite a few albums of him singing in Spanish, and we have a few of those. Yeah, definitely a fun way to learn the language. Absolutely,
that's cool. Robert Conrad is. I still can see him daring you to knock the battery off his shoulder.
Yeah. Oh, Robert David Hall, I'm so glad you could spend the hour with us, man. It's been so uplifting and enlightening, man. I really appreciate it.
Erica, a pleasure, Tomas. Great to meet you both. And all my love to your listeners. Just great.
Oh, thank you so much, man. But guys, be sure to check it out. Season premiere, CSI. It's the 15th season. Can you believe it? It seems like just yesterday. 15 seasons, and it comes on the air September 28th. That's this Sunday coming up. Guys, be sure not to miss it. It's one not to be missed. Check out Ted Danson and our own Robert David Hall as the coroner. Have you seen his character on CSI?
You know, I'm going to have to check it out a little bit more carefully.
Yeah, I think you'll like his character. The coroner's an interesting guy.
Yeah.
Memorable.
I've seen other coroner parts, and they're always a little kooky.
Yeah, there's the gravedigger type, and then there's the kind of exuberant nutcase, and you'll have to see what Robert's character is on the show. It's pretty interesting.
I'm definitely going to check it out.
Hey, guys, stick around. More great stuff, celebrity news, and so much more right here on the PM Show. I'm Eric Hines. Across the glass is the fabulous Tomas. We'll be back right after these messages on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
Hi, I'm Larry Manetti from Magnum PI. Remember me? I played Rick. And over the years, I've been asked so many times to republish my book, Aloha Magnum, which is a 5-star hit. Well, folks, I did it. If you want to see the behind-the-scenes episodes and all the naughty, naughty things that went on Magnum PI, you go to the internet and punch up LarryManetti.com, and Aloha Magnum is there at your reach. I thank you for your loyalty. Take care, folks.
Your parents spent their whole lives looking out for you, but now the roles have reversed. More than 30 million Americans care for an aging parent. But if you're one of them, it's easy to feel like you're in it alone. Navigating programs like Medicare can be confusing, but caregiveraction.org and MedicareMadeClear.com/caregiver can connect you to resources that can help you help your loved one.
make caring for your loved one a bit easier and learn more about Medicare today.
Have you ever considered adding a home security system but thought it would be too expensive? Here's the good news. There's never been a more affordable time to help protect your home, valuables, and your loved ones. You can now get a $100 Visa card from Protect Your Home, your authorized ADT dealer, with the installation of a new ADT monitored system. Here's even better news. Your new system, worth $850, is free. You pay just a $99 installation charge and purchase monthly monitoring for less than $2 a day. Call Protect Your Home today at 1-866-669-8954. That's 1-866-669-8954. Get the peace of mind that comes with owning an ADT monitored system, plus a $100 Visa card from Protect Your Home. Call now 1-866-669-8954. That's 1-866-669-8954. 36-month monitoring contract required. General terms and conditions apply. Visit protectyourhome.com/terms.
What's your IRS problem? Do you owe back taxes? Is there a lien placed on your property? Have your bank accounts been frozen or seized? Have your wages been garnished? Are you being audited by the IRS? Are they sending you letters that demand actions and have urgent due dates? Well, solving your tax problems is as easy as calling Taxes321. The IRS is the largest collection agency in the world. You need the best representation to give you peace of mind. You need experienced professionals that can cut through the red tape and stop the collection process. If you have a serious problem with the IRS, call the Taxes 321 Network today. We'll get them off your back.
800-511-3022. 800-511-3022. 800-511-3022. 800-511-3022.
Just stop and take a little time out with me. Just take five.
Take five. Welcome back, everybody. This is the PM show. Larry and Nancy Manetti on assignment, gallivanting across the world. Guys, if you missed any portion of the show, be sure to check out the website, crntalk.com. That's crntalk.com. Downloads archives of all your favorite shows, including this one, where we have been talking to Robert David Hall, star of CSI, and talking about his music career. Guys, I really got to tell you, go out there and check it out. The CD, Robert David Hall, Things They Don't Teach You in School. Very great music.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I could really see the Texas or the Tejas.
The Tejas.
Feeling in that music. Because, you know, Texas being one of the, you know, states.
It's kind of southern in a way.
It's southern.
Kind of southern,
but
not.
It's modern.
Yeah, modern southern. They established themselves like their own.
Yeah.
So, they weren't really part of the South, but they still kind of have that Southern way about them.
Yeah, exactly.
Similar way. Yeah.
And I remember driving through parts of Texas, San Antonio, and, you know, my mom was showing me a couple things, and I said, wow, I can really feel a different kind of vibe.
You know, people often tell me that Texas is a nice place to live. If you want a great state to live in, Texas is a great place to live.
Yeah, then in Louisiana, I get that.
Louisiana got ghosts, though. Ooh, there's all kinds of ghosts in Louisiana, man.
Yeah,
That's a scary place, man.
Yeah, well, if you step on the wrong corner on the wrong block,
one of those ghosts might get you. Yeah. You know, we were so wrapped up in talking with Robert David Hall. You know, I forgot we had some news stories, so I'm going to just kind of go over a couple of these really quickly here, Tomas. Apparently, people are microwaving their iPhones, and for allegedly a good reason. This is all part of a prank, though.
Oh.
And I got to tell you this, although most of us would never, ever put any Apple product inside of a microwave, a few iPhone users have been tricked into nuking their smartphones. Pranksters over at the 4chan, you know, the internet resource 4chan, ran a false ad that claimed that iOS 8 had a new feature which allowed their iPhone to gain power from microwaves.
Oh, yeah. No.
Of course, as many people who have posted on Twitter about their attempting to recharge the device in the place that radiates your food would now agree, putting your iPhone into a microwave is, in fact, a horrendous idea. So don't try this at home. Yeah, I guess some people fall for it. Some people don't.
Yep.
I guess these guys fell for it. The guy who pretended to be a police officer for more than 20 years, authorities became aware of suspect Jim Bailey, otherwise known as Officer Jim, last month after he tried to break up a dispute between a couple in a car by identifying himself as a retired cop and telling a witness to call 911. Oak Harbor Police Chief Edgar Green said an investigation determined the 69-year-old Bailey had been pretending to be a retired officer for more than 20 years. Impersonating a police officer is a gross misdemeanor. Interesting. So it's not a felony. It's a misdemeanor to impersonate a police officer in Washington. Bailey's attorney said the situation is a misunderstanding, and Bailey, who was arrested last week, is really a good Samaritan who tried to help. A message left Friday by the Associated Press for attorney Christian Skinner wasn't immediately returned. Bailey spent a few years as an Oak Harbor Reserve officer in the late 1980s, but did not graduate from the academy. So he was never officially an officer, and so with that, he had been impersonating an officer. Yeah. So, and of course, I talked about it briefly. Chris and Bruce Jenner, $60 million split. Looks like they're breaking up that big nest egg into two parts here. Chris gets the Hidden Hills estate. Bruce gets to keep his Sherwood Country Club membership. There's no spousal support. The property gets divided, and that is that.
Interesting.
I gotta say, Bruce Jenner's life about to be a lot less stressful in about 10, 9. Guys, remember, if you missed any portion of the show, be sure to check out the website. CRNtalk.com is the website to go to. Download archives of all your favorite shows, including this one. And Froggy's not here today, Tomas, unfortunately. So we will wish our best to Nancy, to Larry, to Froggy. Hi, kids. Hiya. And, of course, to all of us out there in the listening audience. And, of course, to our lovely producer, Courtney Cadera, who put this thing all together. Thank you for booking these great guests and these great stories. Arrivederci, everyone.
Adios, amigos.
CRN Digital Talk Radio prides itself on being the station of every situation. Of course, you can always listen live through your local cable TV provider, as well as on our website at crntalk.com. But if cutting-edge technology is more your style, you'll be happy to know that CRN is now available on Wi-Fi radio. Simply log on to Receiva,